Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
At this time, I will ask Mr. Manning if he will give an invitation, please.
Thank you, Chairman Massey. Let us pray. Our Father, we are grateful for the opportunity to meet, do the work of the county. We ask your guidance, and we pray that you will take care of the staff, of the board, the citizens of Alamance County. We ask also and we pray for our servicemen overseas, particularly at this time of year, that you will guide and allow them to come home soon with their families. And during this special time of year when we celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, let us all think and reflect and help us that we can and will do goodwill unto men and have peace on earth and work toward that goal. Bless now, as we begin this meeting, that you will watch over us and guide us, and we pray that we will do the right things and make the right decisions. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. We do not have any public comments, so we won't have any commissioner responses, I guess. At this time, I want to, we'll have the appointment of the Register of Deeds. I think we have to make a motion to accept that first. So at this time, Mr. Hugh Webster, if you'll just stand, and so everybody will know who you are. And this is Hugh Webster, who the Republican Party has nominated for this position, and I will entertain a motion to accept their nomination.
I'll make a motion.
Have a motion second. To accept and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. No opposed? Okay. Now we can do that. Now we can do the swearing in. So if you want to come up front. Oh, I'm sorry.
If you would approach. It's my privilege and pleasure to do this, sir. Thank you very much. Do we have a Bible?
Yes.
Here's one. Would you please place your left hand on the Bible and repeat after me, raising your right hand. I, state your name.
I, Hugh Webster.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties
of my office as Register of Deeds.
Of my office as Register of Deeds
for the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, and state your name.
I, Hugh Webster.
Do swear that I will faithfully.
Do swear that I will faithfully.
And truly execute the duties of the office.
And truly execute the duties of office.
Of Register of Deeds for the County of Alamance.
Of Register of Deeds for the County of Alamance.
According to the best of my skill and ability.
According to the best of my skill and ability.
In all things according to law.
In all things according to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you, sir.
How are you?
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Webster.
Congratulations.
Mr. Webster, if you'll sign right there, please.
And Judge Abernathy, it's a pleasure to see you here. Yeah.
Well, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here on this momentous occasion. It sounded like we both have a little bit of a cold here.
Mm-hmm.
Sign another original for you, I'll be glad to later on, okay? And I'll be back with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge Abernathy.
Thank you. I'll sign another if you want, okay?
Chairwoman Massey, thank you, and the commissioners. God bless y'all.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay, Jason, would you come forward, please? You want to talk about your appointments? We're going with the planning board appointments.
Madam Chair, Commissioners, good evening. In your package, you should have a memorandum from me regarding the planning board reappointments and filling of planning board vacancy. The planning board voted unanimously on December 9th at their regular meeting to recommend Robert Osborne of Newland Township to fill a vacancy that is being created by the departure of Rodney Cheek, who was coming off the board after serving two terms. Mr. Osborne is an electrical engineer for Underwriters Laboratories Incorporated. And as I said, he was recommended unanimously by the planning board. In your packet, you also have the other applicants that were considered at the same time for that. Just wanted to make you aware of that. And at the top of Mr. Osborne's was the recommendation. Additionally, Steve Love and Jane Isley are eligible for reappointment and wish to be reappointed there, as well as Ken Walker for a one-year appointment, which would fill out his 6 years on the board. Their reappointments are unanimously supported by the planning board as well. And with that, I'll be glad to take any questions you all have at this time.
No, I'd just like to make a comment about the planning board. It was tough. They had some really good candidates apply for the position, and they had a hard time making that decision. But I think Mr. Osborne would be a great addition to the board.
Need a motion?
This time I'll entertain a motion to accept these people. And I have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
No opposed. All right. Thank you, Jason. Okay, next is you again.
Me again.
The award of the CDBG administrative contracts.
Okay, also in your package, you should have two memorandums. I did this on two separate memorandums because they are two different grants. The first one is for the 2010 Scattered Sites Community Development Block Grant for housing rehabilitation. This is a $400,000 grant that the county receives every 3 years to do low to moderate income housing repair or rehabilitation. And this is for the administrative services for the grant. Just for the record, there were no matching funds required in this grant or anything, so there's no county funds tied into it. The county did advertise at large as well as direct solicit three separate companies for their services on this grant. And when the window for the bids closed on the 19th of November, we received bids from two companies. One is from Hobbs Upchurch and Associates, and the other from Sierra Structures. And you should have here, as well as the rankings there that we gave them based on their experiences, experience with the county, experience with CDBG grants, with community assistance grants, and the needs of the county. And based on our ranking, we do recommend Hobbs Upchurch and Associates be awarded that grant. And on the other grant was the North Carolina CDBG Economic Recovery Program grant. This is a $500,000 grant. It's very similar to the Scattered Sites Rehab grant. This is going to be also used to repair homes for low to moderate income residents in the county. And we received bids from the same two companies there. And based on the same criteria, we have also recommended Hobbs Upchurch and Associates for that grant as well. And also for the record, that grant does not have any county matching funds attached to it either. Okay. With that, I'll be glad to take any questions you all have at this time. And I believe Michael Walser is here from Hobbs Upchurch and Associates as well, if you have any questions for him.
Okay. Am I having questions? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept these grants and these contracts.
I'll make a motion that we accept.
Okay. Have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
No opposed? All right. Thank you, Jason.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Jason.
Okay. Next is MG. There you are. It's library amendment.
Madam Chair, Commissioners,
I have a budget amendment that you should have a memo in your packet. We approved a budget that projected to receive $1,086,499 in state aid as revenue. And because we were below our maintenance of effort this year, that amount was cut to $185,194 for a difference of $1,305 in our projected revenues.
Okay. Anybody got any questions on that? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept this amendment.
I'll make the motion to accept.
Have a motion to accept and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, likewise. Thank you. Thank you, MJ. Okay, next is the tax certification law. Mr. Albright.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I come before you tonight to ask your permission to file a local bill with our General Assembly in January of this upcoming year. And this bill will allow us to request the General Assembly amend North Carolina General Statute 161-31 that will permit this board to pass a resolution requiring a registered deeds not accept a deed for recording unless county taxes have been paid. And 68 other counties have added on to this legislation over the past 10 years, and I would request that this board allow me to present a bill before the General Assembly. I think you have a copy of a draft bill.
In the past, that's been just transferred to new owners.
That's correct. We've had so many foreclosures this year, we felt like this would be a good time for us to have this power, and the taxes will be paid when it's transferred.
Some of them did that now. About 68 of them. The last one I did was paid. And that covers the county by doing that.
It saves time and gives us another tool in our bag to collect taxes.
Okay. Any questions?
Now, on an automobile, that's always been the case, isn't it? I mean,
well, yes. The Department of Motor Vehicles is not supposed to register or issue a tag renewal if taxes are owed.
But it has caused confusion in the past because some of them would get their bill and they wouldn't know what to do with it. And it hadn't been
depending on who closed loans and stuff, it would be very confusing.
That's true. Okay. So I would request a motion to allow me to
for that.
All
right. This time I'll entertain a motion. Have a motion.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
You made a fast trip back for a fast meeting.
Okay, and the next thing is Mr. Burgess, and he's ready too.
I'll try not to slow things down. I'll proceed on. Madam Chair, members of the board, good evening. You do have before you, as a follow-up to your September 7th, 2010 meeting, a capital project ordinance, which will need to be adopted tonight so that we can continue moving forward with the probation and parole modular project. The ordinance before you does list the anticipated expenditures and anticipated revenue source and does give the county to the authority to reimburse itself for expenditures that will be made prior to closing on the loan. Before you approve that, I'll just give you a quick update of where we are on the modular project. As I said, it is moving forward. We hope to have the demolition, grading, modular, and financing contracts to you at one of your meetings in April for you to approve. Hope to close on the loan in May, and then hope to have the project finished up by October. So that's kind of the time schedule we're looking at. That is tentative, could change, but that's what we're looking at this point. So I'd ask that you would adopt that ordinance so that we can continue working on the project.
Do I have any questions? Is this modular similar to the one at Pleasant Grove, or is it bigger?
It'll be about,
I remember,
probably about 4.5 times that size.
I knew it was
similar
bigger
in structure, yes.
Well, they love it out,
yes,
there.
I think they're very pleased with it, and it turned out very well.
Okay, I'm new. Where is this going to be?
This will be behind the jail annex on Prison Camp Road, and it'll be located behind that.
Thank you.
I don't have any questions. I'll make a motion that we accept this.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you for your time.
Have a Merry Christmas.
Okay, next is the county manager reports.
Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. With the board's permission, we would like to cancel the January 3rd meeting. That is the meeting right after the first of the year. We'll be closed on the 31st for New Year's as well. So not a lot going on, and also with the holidays, not a lot of time to get our agenda packets ready. Our next meeting would be held on January 18th. That is the Tuesday after Martin Luther King's Day. But we need a motion to approve that.
Okay, I hear a motion.
So moved.
Have a motion, a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
And I do have one other thing that I did want to mention. Tonight is our clerk, Pat Jones' final meeting. Pat has been a fixture here in Alamance County for over 20 years. Pat has been instrumental in many, many ways and many different projects, and just all of her help that she has given staff and the boards throughout the years, and she is greatly going to be missed. We want to thank her for years of dedication and service to the county. I do also want to thank her for the last month and a half. She's worked very closely with our new clerk, Tori Frank, and making sure that when the first comes, that Tori will be able to hit the ground running, hopefully with little to no lag time. And so Tori's excited about that as well. But I do want to let Pat know we'll miss her, we love her, and thank you for all that you've done for Alamance County.
Have anybody to say yo, Pat, to?
Yo, Tori.
Yep, I have to change that to yo, Tori.
I do want to, we are having a drop-in reception for Pat this coming Wednesday. This coming Wednesday from 2 to 4. So if you're in the area, it'll be here in the commissioner's chambers.
I think, does anybody have it, or is that okay? Are we through with her? No, we're not through with you.
No.
yeah, and I just want to thank Pat, too, for everything she's helped me with. Because I was green as a gourd when I got on here. Not totally green, but she has helped me quite a bit with the things in the county, because she knows everything about this county, I'm here to tell you. So, but Tori will learn. So we look forward to working with Tori. She's a fast learner, Pat says. So we look forward to working with Tori as well. So. Thank you. Anybody got anything on the consent agenda that they want to talk about or remove at this point? I think everybody is okay with their appointments.
Except that's good.
What are you trying to break a world record
there? I know, she is, isn't
she? What can you tell us about the voting delegates?
The voting delegates, okay.
You're the one that's going to
vote. She's going.
Yes, sir. Every year at the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners, they have items that they present to the
legislature.
And actually, there should be something in here on that.
Yeah, we had an email to it.
The e-news update here is in your pack. Well, it was put on your desk tonight. And I tried to find everything about what they were, and I couldn't find it, and Craig didn't find all the legislative proposals either. But I am a voting delegate, and I vote whether I want them to yes or no, to say, yeah, we want to do this or we want to do that. And hopefully I will get something before January 20th or 21st and get it to you guys, because I want you to look at it. And because the first year I went, I had no idea what I was doing. And I called Harold Owens, actually, on the Jordan Lake rules. And I'm like, tell me what I'm supposed to do here, because I had no idea. And so I don't know how many people had been going prior to me coming on the board, or if anybody had been going. Maybe Larry went. I don't know. Did Larry go to some of those two paths? But anyway... unless one of y'all want to go and be the voting delegate now. I don't have a problem with it. But, and actually, Craig and I will be driving down together for that. It's too close to spend the night. So, and I don't want to spend the night anyway. But That's what it is, and that gives me a chance to either vote yea or nay, whether we like that proposal or not. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we'll have some for you. I couldn't find it today.
There's a general list of items that the association is looking at recommending to the General Assembly. And we would request that you look at that. If you have questions or concerns or need additional information, please let me know. We'll make sure to get that for you.
Yeah, it's in here. Okay, does that answer your question?
Yes, it does. Thank you.
Anything else? Otherwise, I will ask for a motion to accept the consent agenda.
So moved.
Have a motion?
Second.
And a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Commissioners' comments. It's time I wait for the commissioners' comments.
I'd like to say that it has been a pleasure to work with Pat. The last 14 years I've been on the commission, she's, when I had a question, I could always call her and find out the answer. Thank you so much for your help.
I've only been here a couple years, but I really have appreciated your help, Pat. You've done a great job and just keep us right informed of where we should be and when we should be there. So.
And I'll just say for the past 6 weeks, ditto.
And we're going to miss you.
Any other comments? Okay. Any announcements? Well.
What? Everybody's quiet as Christmas.
There are no announcements. We are adjourned.
All right.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.